I didn't really want to come into medicine, but once I had my first patient interaction here, I was really in love with the field and really wanted to do this. My first shadowy experience, and it was with the surgical oncologist. And then with the recovery room, you see patients right after surgery, and they're usually there for a couple days, or if not, like few hours before they go home. So just seeing like the thrill on like the family members of the patient's faces was something that was truly inspiring to actually be in the field like that. I was exposed to seeing the first physician of color and like I've ever have seen in my life. So when I was able to see that people actually looked like me, like being there, it was pretty much a motivation for me to continue going and understand that I might have to sacrifice a lot, but at the end of the day, I will get where I want to be in life.
As part of the hospital medicine program, one of the things I think we felt was that at some point during the COVID-19 pandemic, there was a definite shift in the patient population. I don't think I've ever spoken so much Spanish, medical Spanish in my life. And so now we're taking a hard look at that data, the COVID-19 data, looking at healthcare disparities, looking at how much of those patients were speaking Spanish, how much of them actually received translation and how they received that translation, how many of those received intubation, were discharged on oxygen. So we're taking a hard look at that data. These pipeline and pathway programs are important, and the more individuals we see, like Jaylene, they have those unique perspectives. They know what our patients have gone through. They know the lived experiences that our patients have gone through so that we can better take care of these patients.